channel. Today's video is going to be another makeup haul, specifically from Sephora and Ulta. I don't get to go to Ulta very often, and just the other day when I did, I posted a picture of my bag on Instagram, and all of you wanted to see a haul. You guys seem to love hauls, and I love filming them, so it's just awesome. I actually have been giveaway shopping, and I'm really excited to announce that I will be doing a pretty big giveaway at the end of April. Now, I know that's far away, but it's my 1 year YouTube anniversary, and I just kind of wanted to combine everything and do one big giveaway for you guys. So please leave me a giveaway ideas down below. I'm not going to share with you everything I got just because I want it to be a surprise, but I did get a few things for you guys and then a few things for myself. So jumping into the things that I got for myself, I really wanted to try out this Sephora aerosol foundation after seeing It's Duty Time do a first impression of this, and I got the shade Fair. They only had about 5 colors, but I have had the Dior one that they seem to kind of be copying in a way, and I really used to like that, but it's like upwards of $60, and It's Duty Time said that this was really great, so I haven't gotten a chance to use that yet, but I did pick that up. Next thing that I did get for myself is another YSL Rouge Volupt Shine Lipstick. And if you guys have been with me for a while, you know that I love the Fuchsia in Excess one from Sephora. It's absolutely great. So this time around, I went with a red and I am wearing it on my lips today. This is number 4 and the shade name is Rouge in Danger. As always, the packaging is gorgeous, and I literally just feel like every girl needs a really nice red lipstick. Now, don't get me wrong, I do have a ton of red lipsticks in my collection, but this one is just perfect because of the formula. I've raved about the YSL formula of lipsticks before, but they're so lightweight, they smell amazing, they wear wonderfully, and they're just not even drying at all on my lips, so love them, love them, love them. Now, sorry if you hear something in the background. My parents actually just got back from the store, but moving right along, this next product is amazing, and I just ran across it in Sephora. I think they're new, but they are from Dior, and it says that they're the Dior Show Fusion Mono Long-Wearing Professional Mirror Shine Eyeshadows. Now, I think I just randomly picked these up, and the color I got was 821 Shy Marie. I'm probably saying that super wrong. Now, these eyeshadows are seriously to die for if you're girly like me and you love some shine. These are very, very glittery, but the feel of them is super buttery. I can't even explain it. I'll be doing a first impression of this on my Instagram for sure, but this color is perfect for every single day, and even though it's super shimmery, this color in particular out of the whole line was the most wearable. So I totally see this being a color that I can just sweep across my lid on a daily basis, maybe with some black eyeliner, and it's just going to look beautiful. I will say the application is so much better with your finger. You just get a really nice opaque color really, really quickly. And with a brush, it's kind of a little bit harder, but I am falling in love with this so, so much since I got it. So the last 3 things in that Sephora bag are all for you guys, so I'm just gonna skip over those because I don't want to ruin the surprise. So moving on to Ulta. Now, I went there for one reason and one reason only, and then came out with a ton more stuff, but the reason I went is for the new Too Faced mascara, the Better Than Sex mascara. This stuff is raved about, and it's only been around for a really short amount of time, but I had to get 2 of them, one being for you guys. So I'm just going to throw that in the Sephora bag with all of your other prizes, but yes, the Too Faced mascara, everyone I've ran into raves about it. I have not gotten to use it yet, but just from the reviews and everything I've been hearing, it's like life-changing, and the packaging is amazing. So when I did go to Sephora that first time and I bought your giveaway prizes, they didn't have one of these in stock. It was crazy. So then I like called up Ulta and I'm like, do you guys have this? And she's like, yes, we only have a few. And I'm like, hold 2 for me, please. Ran up there and then came away with all of this stuff. So yes, this is the thing I went for, and I can't wait to try it. So then other than that mascara, I did get a few other things. One being the Not Your Mother's Naughty to Nice Conditioning Detangler. And I am always in need of detangler. I have really fine, thin hair. And the one I'm using right now is pretty old and just from Pantene. And of course, I want to try something new. So this kind of spilled everywhere because I think it froze overnight in my car, which probably wasn't the best idea. But from what I'm smelling, it smells amazing. And luckily, it didn't get too crazy and all over everything. But I'm just hoping that the little sprayer still works. I think it will, but I'm really excited to try this, and I think I heard Miss Glamorazzi rave about this kind of a while ago, and I've been looking for it ever since then, so I'm really excited for it. Another hair thing is this Batiste Dry Shampoo, A Hint of Color, for dark and deep brown hair. Now, I've never tried a colored dry shampoo. I did use this today to just freshen up my hair a little bit because this is second day hair. But who did I hear rave about this? I think it was actually in a Makeup Geek collaboration video with, is it Talia or something like that? I'm not too sure, but I think she raved about this, which is why I wanted to get it. And I did find it at Ulta. She said that you could get it also at Walgreens. Next up is this mascara from Essence, and this is their I Love Extreme mascara. And I had to pick this up because Emily Eddington over on Beauty Broadcast does an Emily Awards every single year, and she's in the process of putting out the videos right now. They're so, so entertaining. I'm sure a ton of you watch them, but if you don't, I'll include some of the links down below because they're just so fun to watch. But this is an award winner for this year, I think, for drugstore mascara. And the brush is very interesting. I'll quickly show it to you guys. It has super, super tiny little bristles, and it looks like it could clump pretty easily, but she says that it doesn't, so I'm super duper excited to try this out. And last but not least is another Real Techniques brush. I only have a few of these in my collection, but this one just really caught my eye. It is their blush brush, but I really feel like this could be a powder brush as well. But these brushes are great quality, and they're pretty inexpensive. I can only find them at Ulta, so if you have one around you, I definitely go check there, but they are great quality also, and I love how they have the little colored handles. I think they're just so cute. So that is everything that I've recently picked up on my shopping trips, and I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please make sure to check out all of my social media links down below. I'm on Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, and Instagram all of the time, so please come say hi over there. Also, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of my new videos, and give this video a huge thumbs up if you want more future hauls. But other than that, I hope you guys are having a great day, and I have an amazing video coming out soon, as well as tons of other ones, but one in particular I'm really excited about because it's going to be a collaboration for Valentine's Day. But guys, like I said, have a great day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, everyone.